praise God for the saints, for our visitors, for the absent part of the body, for Elder Robinson, amen, the deacons, the elders, amen, the praise and worship team, the musicians, amen, for my wife, amen. I'm just glad to be in God's house one more time. Even just, again, on this morning, just thinking about the saints of God, and just, Lord, you know, what would you have me to say to your people today concerning your word? Amen. And sometimes, amen, when God gives you a word, you begin to, you know, look around the congregation, amen, to, you know, who is he directly speaking to? But sometimes, amen, God does not give you a face, amen, but he gives you situations, amen, that we have to understand that God, amen, is in control of our lives no matter what it is that we're going through. So saints of God, don't get flighty, amen. Don't get discouraged, don't get dismayed, but you got to wait on the Lord. And that's what James here, he begins to say to the 12 tribes, amen, that are scattered abroad. He tells them, greeted, amen. And when you think about this, these 12 tribes of Israel, they've been scattered. But he sends one collective word, amen. He's telling them, greetings, amen. He tells them, he says, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. So we begin to understand something, amen, that when they were supposed to present themselves unto the Lord, amen, being scattered abroad, some of those, amen, that are scattered might not have been able, amen, to gather Jerusalem at the appointed time. But God also made a provision for those, amen, that were scattered. If you can't get there, you still had to offer up a sacrifice. So saints of God, sometimes when we find ourselves cannot get to the house of God, we still have to offer up a sacrifice of praise. Yes. Some people sometimes when they feel like, amen, they can't make it to the house of God, it's a day off, amen. Amen. But it's not a day off, amen. But it's sometimes there's some things that might hinder you from getting to God's house, but you still say, God, I just want to thank you. You still tell God, amen, my desire is to be in your house. My desire, praise our God. So sometimes when people go on vacation, sometimes you're out there, you know, you can't get to God's house, and 11 o'clock roll around, you say they're just not in Sunday school, you begin to think, amen, as you were there, what was going on. So begin to understand something here, that the title, amen, is wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord, and sometimes we begin to realize, amen, that when we're trying to wait on the Lord, praise our God, that our patience, praise our God, it becomes short. It becomes short fused because this flesh does not want to wait on pretty much anything. But when it comes down to waiting on God, amen, there's always a struggle for those that are in the body of Christ. I'm here to tell you that sometimes, saints of God, we all, praise be to God, are going through something at some time or one place or another. We all encounter ups and downs. The ups, amen, being the good times, and the downs being those things that are sometimes that are difficult in our lives. So we begin to realize, amen, that the song, amen, that I wouldn't mind, amen, singing if I have a voice, is that I don't mind waiting on the Lord. But the song, amen, just says that. I don't mind waiting on the Lord. He says, I don't mind waiting on the Lord. So no matter what I'm going through, I begin to realize that if I just wait on God, that he's going to make everything all right. And so that's why he says here, he says, brother, he said, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, amen. When you fall, amen, into a situation that is not conducive to your spiritual warfare, amen. He said, you still got to count it all joy. The joy of the Lord becomes our strength. But when a saint of God falls, amen, into these types of temptations, he said, knowing this, that the trying of your faith, amen, is there to work some patience in you. So sometimes, saints of God, we find ourselves, amen, going through the storms of life, we find ourselves waiting on God. He said, God, if you just get me through this storm, whatever the storm is in your life, sometimes it might be financial difficulties, it's a storm. Sometimes it might be a marital relationship, it's a storm. Sometimes, praise our God, it's just that person that's on the job that's always jarring at you. It's a temptation sometimes to want to stand up and fight back. But if I wait on God, he said, I'll fight your battle. Can you imagine Moses with 4 million people and trying to get them to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord? That's a lot of folk, amen, they got to deal with. That's a lot of people you got to tell, you got to wait on the Lord. But he don't know what I'm going through. My children are acting up. How can you tell me to wait on the Lord? But I'm telling you, sometimes, saints of God, you got to learn, amen, to sit back and Sometimes, amen, we got to learn, praise our God, to put on, amen, the Lord Jesus Christ, and to make no provisions for this flesh. We got to keep this flesh under subjection at all times. He said, but let patience have a perfect work. Let patience, amen, have a perfect work. He said, allow it, amen, to do the things that it was supposed to do. Have you ever put something on the stove, praise our God, and it said, let it cook for 14 minutes, and at minute number 10, we still want to look at it and do some things with, but you got to let those 14 minutes come up, praise be to God. And when 14 minutes comes, there it is, praise be to God. If you set the temperature where it's supposed to be, if you put the right amount of, I'm talking about some grits, y'all, if you put it where it's supposed to be, come find waiting on the Lord. So these grits, praise be to God, they'll fit, amen, they'll nice. So if you can just wait and have that patience and not to get in there and start throwing things around, you'll learn, amen, that it's good to your soul. So what's it says here? He said that you may be perfect and entire. This word perfect means complete in God. You complete, my God, and not wanting anything from the Lord. Wanting nothing. But he said, you have not because you ask not. A lot of things that we desire from God, praise our God, we got to wait God and say, Lord, if it be thy will that I might have this. And when God says no, you got to be willing to accept what God has allowed. So we begin to look at this thing. He says, listen, when we take this and yes, I can wait on God. Can you really wait? And sometime I remember my wife talking about our son, Quincy. Quincy was the type of child, amen, that you could sit him down in the front row and he would sit there. But the other one, amen, glory be to God. You come back 2 minutes later, that brother is gone. And so do the saints of God at sometimes. They can wait on God, but don't let that clock, amen, start ticking just a little long. Then we're going to start wondering, where is God? He's supposed to be here by now. I remember my grandfather. If you told him you're going to be there at 5 o'clock, 5:01, my God, he's pacing, looking for you. Glory be to God. But how many know that our time is not God's time? Listen, we got to understand that when God moves, he moves at his pace. And that's why we got to follow the cadence of the Lord.
All right, come on.
Amen. I don't know who I'm talking to, amen, but God is telling you, he said, you got to wait on me. You got to wait. You got to take this thing seriously. God is telling somebody to wait this morning. We're going to go through some hardships, but God is telling you to wait. Oftentimes, amen, sometimes when it's said it's too good to be true, it probably is. Can you wait on God? Can you wait for that situation, amen, to settle in your spirit? To say, God can speak, say, this is not a good situation for you to come yourself into. And so sometimes we get ahead of God and then we make a shipwreck of what God has already told us to wait on.
All right.
Saints of God, we're going to have problems in this life. We're going to get sick at times. Some of us, amen, have been even sick unto death. But God, hallelujah, he raised us up. Sometimes we're going to have tragedies in our family. I lost my mother here in November, but I remember what God said in his word. He said, you can think about those things that your mother taught you. You can go down that road, he said, but you got to wait on me to bring you back. In other words, you can think about your mother all day long, and I won't let you get depressed. He said, you can go down that road, but I'll bring you out. So I'm here to tell somebody, think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he has done for you. Every time that thought comes to mind, I can look back and think about how good she was to us. Sometimes, amen, some people might find themselves out of work, but can you still wait on God? Sometimes, amen, problems just arise. Amen, the problems of life, sometimes tragedies or what, they're commonplace now for us, but we got to wait on God. So we got to give these things unto the Lord. Some things, amen, we can handle ourselves, but there are some battles, amen, that belongs to the Lord. And that's where the waiting comes in. That's why John, amen, the 16th chapter, verse number 33, he said, listen, he said, these things have I spoken to you that ye might have peace. He said, in the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. He said, for I have overcome the world. So when somebody tells you, cheer up, brother, they mean cheer up in the Lord. They're telling you, amen, because the enemy of our soul to come to buffet us about, he come, amen, to shake us, amen. He come, amen, to cause us to lose faith and confidence in God. But be of good cheer, because God says, I have overcome the world. And the Bible says we're in the world, but we're not of this thing. So sometimes, amen, you got to step back and take a self-evaluation and say, am I dabbling in the world? Yes, glory be to God. And some of us are. We're out there trying to have one foot in the world and another foot in church. But God said, listen, he said, I wish you were either hot or cold. He said, if you're lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. So listen, you're not hearkening, amen. God knows exactly where you are. There's a couple of things, praise be to God, that sometimes our trials and tests come. Storms of life come to help us, amen, to stay on track with God. And also sometimes struggles, praise God, and hardship, amen, it comes about, amen, to shake the impurities that's in our lives. I remember, amen, being in the Navy, praise be to God. We had this thing called a 72-hour checkoff list. And sometimes, praise God, every hour, amen, we had to go through and mark that we got this checked off before the ship can get underway. And sometimes we had to get to a point, each watch station, each duty station had the responsibility to do. And some of the responsibility, you get down there to 24 hours, you got that 12-hour checkoff, and lo and behold, you get on the way. But some of those checkoffs were saying, you got to tie these things down. You got to make sure those things, they call them missile hazards, meaning that if the ship take a heavy roll, this thing could fall and hit you and could kill you. So in other words, we had to tie these things down. And so when you're in a storm, these things become hazards. They become flying. See, sometimes we don't realize, amen, the hazard that we go through in our everyday life. That's what we were talking about in the office back there now. People are texting and driving like you wouldn't believe. They don't realize that they're putting themselves in danger and the person that's next to us. But I understand something. That'll stop us from driving. Amen. Glory be to God. No, it doesn't. But it's a hazard that we face, and we accept that responsibility every time we get into our car. So therefore, amen, the captain of the ship, he said, I'm going to see how much the people did this checkoff. I'm going to see that they really tie some things down that should be tied down. And so you get out there, brother, away from land. He kick up the speed just a little bit. And say, right full rudder. And if it ain't tied down, glory be to God. You hear things, boom, boom, boom. You hear things falling out of the overhead ceilings. And he knows, amen, that somebody, ops boss to the bridge, he start calling department heads up. I'm hearing things and things are falling. Lord, don't let nothing fall from the bridge and hit him. But what am I saying? So sometimes in life, praise our God, God is right running us. Glory be to God. Just to see, praise be to God. Do we got some things tied down? Have we fastened down the things in our lives, praise be to God? He said, lay aside the weight and the sin that does so easily beset us. Some of these things that beset us, praise of God, all we got to do is tie them down. Glory be to God. So listen here. I'm here to tell somebody on this morning, when you wait on God, start tying some things down. That wait, that tarry means to wait with expectation that God is going to do something. So I want you to understand, before God begins to move in your life, begin to tie those things down that become missile hazards in your life. Begin to separate yourself from the things that mean you no spiritual good, but you got to learn to wait on God. Amen. How is it, Pastor, that I can find joy in the midst of hardship? Sometimes, amen, when hardship comes, amen, we want to withdraw ourselves. We want to, amen, set ourselves off all by ourselves. But that's not good, praise be to God. In other words, when you fall into these diamond temptations, when hardship comes, we got to start thinking about that God wants to be faithful in this situation, that God wants, amen, to come to him and to seek his face. That's why Isaiah, praise be to God, chapter 12 and verse 2 and 3 said, behold, God is my salvation. He says, I will trust and not be afraid. God has not given up the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. But when the adversary of our soul comes in like a flood, he wants to think everything is going down. But if you stand, my God, firm on the word of God, that's why I say you got to hide it in your hearts that you might not sin against you. Sin is what separates us from God. But when you find yourself waiting on God, you will be separated from him. He said, for the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. That's why I say, if I could sing the song, I don't mind waiting on the Lord. I don't
on the Lord, because the joy of the Lord is my strength. That's why sometimes we laugh at Deacon Davis. He said, I got one song I got to repeat. If that song, my God, keeps the melody in your heart and the thoughts of the adversary are out, then you keep that song on repeat for as long as you drive and on those roads. That's why you got to have a song in your heart that when you come, amen, that you can sing of God's goodness and his mercy. Now listen to me very carefully. Some of these songs out here now, glory be to God, ain't nothing spiritual about it. You know what I'm talking about. Yes. Sometimes I get in my car and I turn on the radio. Man, I'm making sure I got the right station. Yes, it is. It's the right station, but the wrong songs are. Right. And some of these songs that are taken up around the world. He says, also you become my salvation. Therefore, with joy shall you draw water out of the wells of salvation. That's why he said, Jesus, if you drink of this water, you're going to thirst again. But the water I give you, they spring up unto everlasting life. Mm-hmm. This water, he's talking about, is the Holy Ghost. Yeah. Saints of God, we got to realize something. The calling that God has in our life, is much more greater than the pull that the adversary is tugging at our coat.
Come on,
listen to what I'm saying. That call, praise our God, that God has is much more than the adversary is pulling at your coat. That's why he says, greater is he that is in you than he that's in the world. So if Satan got my coat tail, that call of God is greater. I can escape that thing, Lord. It's almost like Joseph, when she was handed by the coat, my God, get this coat. Hallelujah. And he left on the pile there. And that's what sometimes says to the Lord. That's what we got to do. If she got you by the coat, then forget the coat. Glory to God. You can get another coat. Glory to God. It's great. God gives us that power. And that power is nothing but the Holy Ghost. But you got to feed that thing. In other words, the more you feed it, my God, the stronger it becomes. The more you read this word, it becomes alive in you. The more you begin to study and meditate on God's word, and every walk you begin to walk, it begins to say, that's an opportunity for me to wait on God, no matter what I might want to do in the flesh. But my spirit says, you better wait. My spirit begin to tell me, the flesh begin to war against the spirit, but because I'm full of the word of God, that strong voice, I'm not talking about a steel voice, now I'm talking about that strong unction of the Holy Ghost that begins to tell you, son, you better wait, daughter, you better wait on God, hallelujah. But when you begin to rise up and to boast above that, he says, son, you better wait on God, hallelujah. Child of God, you need to wait on the calling of God. I'm telling you, saints, somebody, praise our God, you're going to have to wait today. You're going to have to wait. I'm telling you, if you go ahead of God, you're going to be in the office saying, Pastor, I remember the message that you preached, but guess what? It sounded too good to be true. I didn't even get a chance to call you. I didn't even get a chance to consult you. You better get some wise counsel and wait on God. Amen. The counsel this morning, saints, is waiting on God. If you remember, praise be to God, when Jesus gave him, amen, he says, tarry into Jerusalem till you be endued with power from on high. Right. Listen, these men, they had some strength about them. They was fishermen, so they wasn't no bony people, amen. These men had strength, but he said, you got to wait in Jerusalem till the something from on high comes down and it dwells in your body to give you the strength to wait in my world. Glory be to God. If you ain't got the power of the Holy Ghost, you might not be able to stand the wiles of the devil. Yeah, you might have some bumps in the road. Yes, you will. But God, my God.